Hey guys, I have a video for you today. It's my approach of using custom styles, custom CSS when working in Bubble. This is really helpful for styling default elements and just to go beyond the Bubble limitations to add something that is not by default available in Bubble. And it's just one step from from using just Bubble. Then you can add some custom JavaScript, then you can add some other stuff, but for now let's just focus and discuss a little bit what you can do with CSS and how to do this. So I will explain what is the point of doing this approach, finding the right selector with using Google Developer Console, and how after you found everything, how to do this and save in Bubble so you have new elements. So let's do it. To start with, like I'm working on the app, and we have with team we have a design that was looking something like this. So the slider with price selection here, but the slider is round form. Yeah, I noticed that this is the default slider you see in Bubble. It's by default it's like this, and basically I transformed this one to the round shape one. This is a simple approach, simple thing to do, but by showing how I do this, you can then apply it everywhere. So firstly, as soon as we place the element, we can play with default features. What I mean by this is change some colors here to make it better. For example, clear some borders, then play and the height so it looks better. Now we are thinking about changing only this element because this one, the pointer, we will stylize with CSS. So yeah, at the end we like created something like this. Yeah, we have. So what about these round corners? As soon as we place the element on the page and we use maybe some test page that you're using for testing, because you have live app to not interfere with other elements. But let me show you here. So you need to publish a page with new element. So you got like some kind of better look than the default one, but still not the best, not what you want. Then you click right button and click inspect, and you have this developer console. I always click on this icon here. It can let you hover elements to easily to find it fast. So by clicking, you see a lot of code. You don't need to be familiar with CSS. Actually, it's super easy and it's like game-like. I will show you right now. So, you see on this tab we have a lot of classes. I always looked for the class that makes sense because this is code that's written by a human. Yeah, and usually they try to keep it easier to understand and logically correct, so in the future they can go back to this class and fix something if they need to fix it. For example, I see here is UE slider class here, and I kind of and we have UE slider handle. I kind of you see like this logically this class is related to this element. So let's try to change some borders here. You see, it's changing. Let's try to add something here. You see, we added the border radius, we changed it to zero. But then we see that this background color that we added here, it's overridden by something. Why? Because all the custom CSS that you add usually overwritten by bubble default CSS that's linked to this element. So to use your styling, you need to add after you add the after you the property itself, you add important here. Now we see it's working. So when you're using, this is the a really important point to mention. If you add something that is coming from you, so your custom CSS that you want to add to this element, always add important region like this. Explanation sign, important word before closing the property by this sign. So why I'm using the approach like this, you can easily play with properties here, add some borders, add some I don't know, spacing, depends on the element, depends on the idea that you try to achieve, try colors, try different. As soon as you, if it's not the class that you need, you will not see the changes here. You need to check other classes, you see, and what are you doing? Just inspect, try to change some properties to see what's changing on the element. The developer console, it's super nice to do this. You can just spend like 2 minutes changing different settings to see how these classes relate to this element, and you can easily find the class that you need. Now, As soon as we finished with this, we go to the app itself. We don't need to add anything in the to the element itself. Now we know what which class we are using and which one we need to add to the HTML element. Okay, let's go to the to my old filter that I already changed. You see, I added the HTML element that's called HTML filter tag roundness. I just call it so I understand why is it. Then what we do? We add a custom style. We open a style tag, we close it, and basically here we write the properties that we was playing with and selector that we was playing with in dev console. So we know this UE selector handle, and here you add the properties you like. Here I added the border radius. Also, don't forget to write important. It's really super, like the main thing to say here, because if it's not important, it will be overridden by bubble native properties CSS styles, and it will prioritize the bubble one, not yours, if you will just keep it like this without important word written in the end. So, and here you write the selector dot, and like it was in developer console, and to like this sign here, and here all the properties like one by one. You can add some like background color. You can check just Google CSS properties, or think about what you want to achieve. For example, how to change the sizing, how to change the style, how to change the color of element with CSS. Find the property, it will work here. So all the CSS property available. So it's basically it. This is my approach. So we started with put the element, play with default features, see how what's the limit of default stuff you can change to this element. Then think what is missing, what you want to do with this, what you don't like, what you want to change. Play with it in developer console, change properties. Okay, you like what you see, remember the properties, or even copy paste them somewhere, add HTML and replicate rewrite always all the properties with the selector here. Add a really important, add important word at the end of every line. So if you will have this background color. Again, important. And we close the line. So like this. Now we see we changed the background color to red. So it's basically it. Thank you for watching this video. Please check my links in the description. Some information related to what I'm offering, what I'm doing, my socials, and link to my free community to no code for no code developers. That will help us grow together, discuss some ideas, share what we are doing, and other. Please feel free to join. Leave a like, comments, leave some maybe ideas what I can record next. I want to share a lot of valuable content related to building apps, building products with Bubble and other no-code tools, and mixing code and no-code together. Okay, thanks again, guys. Have a great day and bye-bye.